Depending on the attack, you can make these work, but again, nothing is foolproof in martial arts. If he happens to grab me for some odd reason, he has given me his weapons, given me his wrist and his arm. The danger is not this, it's that that's coming. So the first thing we need to do is taisabaki, is to move our body so that he can't hit me. His intention is not going to be to hold me and talk to me about taking my lunch money. He's going to want to smash me. So I can't stand, and I've seen this all over. People will actually stand here and go like this and start to move without being aware of what's happening. So the first thing I need to do before I apply any lock is to take him on a ride. I call this becoming the tow truck. As soon as someone grabs you, it's now an assault, I can do what I need to. Obviously, hitting is the best thing to do to get them off, but we're gonna do this for principle of martial arts. So what I first do is I grab onto him and I shield myself away from that. And then when I grab here and here, I use my legs to pull him. By pulling him, he has to regain his balance and he cannot hit while he's regaining his balance. Grabs from here, I move quickly, a couple of steps, almost like a spider or a crab walking sideways. Blading yourself, your shoulder becomes a shield, you kind of duck, bending your knees, getting a good stance. Now the next thing he's gonna do is recover, but he's angry now. He's gonna pull back, and that's when I'll apply the lock. That's the secret moment. Practice this with me. A vice grip here, like a bear trap, boom. Hand to hand, elbow does a tremendous amount of work on his arm. This grabs cloth or skin, depending on the person. Everything traps his arm. He now had me, I have him. As I step and pull, he has to regain balance. As he pulls back is when I apply this reversal here to break his wrist. It's very, very painful, and I really haven't done much. I really haven't done much. I've gone from one. When he pulls back, right there, this stays on my chest, but it gyakus, and this bone becomes vulnerable to a break. Using my body to crank his fingers toward his center line, the shomitsu. Are you exaggerating the pain?
No, sir.
It'll break the wrist. There's a reason why we call this the great equalizer, because small people can break a wrist with it. It takes no effort. It's body mechanics here. Now I'm doing several other things which you probably can't see. I'm pinning his foot. If you don't control his lower body, he'll kick, he'll roll, he'll escape, he'll punch, pull a knife out, all kinds of things. So I want to make sure that I use this Toki principle to pin the foot. As I put this on, I'm also taking his arm here and pushing this down. By pushing his arm down, it keeps him from rolling away. If I just do this, he can move and step and get out of it. He can shoot in on your legs and wrestle you. But when I go here and he pulls and I do this, I'm controlling him, not just his arm. Again, I'm using my body to press his fingers in this direction. And I'm also rolling his wrist up. It's not just straight in, it's in and up, like a hamster wheel here. Now, you're going to say, well, can he pull free? Yes, he can pull free right here. He can pull free. But once I lock in the joints in multiple places, he can still pull free. Once I'm here, he cannot. Right here, he can. Right here, he can. But once I apply the lock fully and I have the control of his body, I've changed the angle. This is why it's called Hon Gyaku, because everything is based off of this. Some call it Uda. Here. Now watch. Don't feel anything, do you?
No, sir.
Not quite yet either. But when I pull this down and bend your arm, it's amazingly painful. Now, what should you do when you feel pain and it's about to hurt? Tap. Why do you tap?
So I don't break anything,
mm-hmm.
sir.
Don't forget to tap in the martial arts. It's really, really important. There's no shame in it. Get your ego out. When he taps, he should actually tap me so I can feel it in case it's a loud clash, you have hearing impairment. If he taps his thigh and it's a busy class, I can't hear that. So when you tap out, tap where I can visually see that right there, and then I know to release the pressure. One, snap! hard as you can, it'll break that bone easily. You would jump and pop it. We're friends, and I'm constantly going left to right so I don't destroy his wrist, because his bones are small. So continue to adjust. One, let him do it for you. Gyakute, here, very painful. From there, you can knee, you can kick, whatever you want. Again, this won't work so well. Arm is straight, he can pull, he can punch me, he can kick. Watch his spine here. Very intent. It's intention. Nothing is foolproof, but this is one of the top 10, I would call, wrist reversals for small people. Try and practice that. Go ahead. Couple things to fix. Use your elbow more. Watch your spine. Again, that keeps it from hitting me. When I grab, it's literally, watch, it's just, you can be blind and do this. If I'm here, it's hard to find. But if I do this, it's right there. Your thumb should be on the web. I hate to say the word pressure point because most of them are junk, but if I hold with here, versus this, when I reverse this, it's very easy for him to pull free. If I sink an eagle talon into this, when I turn it over, it's harder for him to get out. So I'm really, think about an eagle claw. This is very important. It's not this casual thing. He'll pull free. So it's here, and dig this down. And I'm crushing his fingers. I'm crushing his fingers as I apply it. Here, but I'm being very nice. Reverse it on your shoulder, watch. Use your arm, like the wing of a bird. My lack of faith is disturbing. Now, if he can get me from here, and it's Darth Vader.
Rebels hidden fort.
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
You can't defeat that. Just give up. But from here, oh, I absorb and go right into the lock again. Very common attack for people putting groceries away. Again, soften and move behind him. There it is again. Feel it, sir?
Yes, sir.
And then if you bend it, boom. If he pulls back, I turn it this way. Hon Gyaku can be done in any direction. Standard direction, unorthodox directions. Okay? How about a hook? Not gonna get it from here. Gotta do other things. Unless, very rare, I may hit, boom, and then catch it from here and make it and apply it. Very unlikely, but possible, low probability. Hook punch, you're just better to hit. Ooh, here works the same. Again, come Dracula. See how he rolled out? You don't want them to roll out. When I'm here, if I don't want them to roll, I just go straight down. Break it. As I move here, I want to put it in this hand, which you didn't do. So when I wave here and I catch, watch what I do. See how I popped it into here. Now I have the Hon Gyaku where I need to be. With a Muso, I have two locks, but it's very different. I can't reach this. In the armor, they had trouble reaching because of the helmet. So what they would have to do is lift this arm and bump it across the shoulder into the position they needed. Not this. It is placing it into this hand. Now I have a Muso with the Hon Gyaku. I have two things. So if he pulls free, I bend this and there's the Hon. His arm is straight. It'll work. I can take him down. But if he pulls free, right there. If he goes to punch, why can't you hit?
Pain.
Yeah, when he goes to punch, these joints tighten up. Isn't that cool? If you go to hit, yeah, these joints tighten from here. Now imagine me just doing it. Ends the fight. Okay, keep going.